To politics now. In the wake of the historical guilty verdicts handed down to disgraced former MP Taito Phillip Field, the debate around customary giving, our Pacific MPs and the pressure they come under has resurfaced. Adrian Stevenon has the story.
He was the golden boy of our Pacific community, the man thousands turned to for help, now guilty of using those people to help himself. Many feel the blurred line between his public and personal affairs stemmed from a clash of cultural beliefs. For new Pacific MP, Peseta Sam Lutuinga, it's a line he's keeping clearly marked.
I separate my affairs, my personal affairs, my business affairs, from those of the electorate office and from those of your constituents. I think that's really important to have that clear demarcation between the two.
Before taking up office, Peseta says he sold up all of his business interests, starting his public life with a clean slate. And he's very careful with any gifts that come through his doors.
We do receive gifts, but we put it on a register and we itemise it, time and date and the type of item, that's how we deal with it.
And in his book, accepting monetary gifts is out of the question.
We haven't received monetary gifts, but we won't receive monetary gifts because it's not part of the work that we do. We are here to serve our community. We are here to assist where we can.
Former Labor MP Vui Markoshi knows all about the pressures of public office. Although much of his time is now dedicated to his family, less than a year ago he was still serving in his electorate. Many showed their appreciation with gifts.
Sometimes you couldn't escape it. If somebody throws a $20 note at your staff member as they're running out the door, and on occasions that would happen, you had a book and you entered it in the book. It might be that when you went somewhere you were given a carton of corned beef and that would go to the local food bank.
As an MP, Vui says most of the people who came to his office were immigrants and overstayers, desperate for his help.
MPs see some awful things when it comes to immigration, but you have to put your hat on and say, these are the rules, we'll try and get you through them, and make the best job you can, because quite often we are the last resort for people. They've been through everyone else.
Pacific MPs we spoke to in the Labor Party all agree that there are challenges that come with their role in public office and meeting cultural expectations, but they say the line that separates the two is very clear.
Taito's fall from grace has affected many in the Pacific community, including those who served alongside him for years.
I think we just share a sadness for somebody who had great promise, somebody who was a friend to a lot of us. And when one of our number or one of our friends falls, it's something that we all feel. But that's the way life has gone.
And for the record, there are currently 5 MPs of Pacific Islands descent currently serving in the New Zealand Parliament.